Today, we are introducing a new video generation model. This model is called Time to Move. What is this model used for? Let's take a quick look. Suppose I have an image here. Then I draw a simple guiding animation. The character moves forward along a specified path. At the same time, I also draw a relatively precise mask. After sampling, I will get a fantastic result. Take a look. It indeed moves forward according to the path we specified, and it features very rich movements. So, this is the new technology we are discussing today. This technology belongs to a type of trajectory guided animation, which is actually quite similar to the ATI technology we discussed previously. We can also find a lot of information on its official website. First, this technology can be used with any video model, for example, the WAM model, the CogVideoX model, and our SVD model. If you want to use this technology within ComfyUI, you can use Kijai's WAM video extension and update it to the latest version. Then we can click to open the example workflow. You will find that Kijai uploaded an example workflow called Time to Move just 2 days ago. You can simply download it and drag it into your ComfyUI interface. I have also built the workflow on RunningHub. Everyone can access this platform through RunningHub in the field of ComfyUI. RunningHub is a fantastic online working platform because whenever new technologies or models appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for RunningHub using the invitation link in my video description, which will give you 1,000 free points. Furthermore, you will receive 100 bonus points simply by logging into RunningHub every day. This way, you can try out your own workflows. Now, after explaining all that, did you notice that there is no model download section here? Therefore, this technology is actually a new type of architecture or a sampling method rather than a specially trained model. Now, let's look at the specific implementation method of this workflow. The overall structure of the workflow is a standard 1:2.2 image-to-video workflow. First, there's the high noise model. I use the 1030 version of the Latent X2V model here. The low noise model below is a very standard KJ version of the low noise model. However, the acceleration LoRa I used here is the 1022 version. This is our VAE. In the most critical section below, we need three reference elements. The first is our original image, which you can consider the first frame. The only processing we need to do on it is using a scaling node to ensure it aligns with our resolution. Similarly, I need a video representing the motion. This doesn't need to be very precise. Take a look, it's just a simple displacement video. The animation elements included here are merely displacement and scaling. We also need the mask of the foreground character, which is very familiar to everyone. We scale this as well. After processing all this content, it converges into this node called WAN Video Add TTM Latent. Notice the name, it is designed to increase a reference condition upon a standard latent. First, we need an original latent. This latent is generated by directly encoding our first frame into the latent space. The motion video serves as a reference. Therefore, with these two inputs, plus the mask we mentioned, we can generate an image embedding. Regarding the prompt section, I made a slight adjustment. I used QWL, which improves the sense of motion. This is then encoded by our text encoder. Below that is the high-low noise sampling. Here, we use 6 steps of sampling. Also, the sampling algorithm is slightly different. DPM ISD is used here. Then, we perform decoding. In this workflow, we generate a little more content during decoding. This content is the result of decoding the high noise model, so it is unclear. However, the overall movement effect is quite visible. That is the final decoded effect. Further down is a comparison. This is the original motion video, and this is the final video we generated. You can see that the overall quality is still very high. When the character is walking, you will notice they have relatively complex movements. Of course, there are also some issues. For example, when her skirt turns around, you might see that one side is white and the other side is black. The reason for this is that we cannot select the character perfectly accurately. Therefore, there are some interfering pixels around the character. These pixels, during sampling, will have some impact on the final result. This entirely depends on what your reference image looks like. Here, I have a Western beauty walking on a crosswalk, which leads to this kind of effect. This is the basic application method we discussed. Now, what should we pay attention to when using this workflow? First, everyone should note that in terms of displacement performance, movement in the horizontal direction is easier to achieve. In contrast, the vertical direction is relatively difficult to achieve, especially when trying to implement displacement animation in the depth direction. For example, let's look at this case here. Our reference image is a beautiful woman walking in a maple forest. Then we designed her displacement animation. I wanted her to walk along the path and move inward. Therefore, the main direction of displacement is on the z-axis, meaning the direction of depth, of course, to match the overall change in scene scale. The character has some scaling applied. Now let's look at the final generated effect. The character actually didn't walk well in the depth direction. She is still moving on the plane. Regarding this most important node, there are two parameters to pay attention to, the start step and the end step. Generally, we apply this motion reference during the high noise model or composition phase. We should try not to use this reference during the sampling phase of the low noise model. In our six-step sampling, the first three steps are high noise and the last three steps are low noise. So here, you should set it to 1 to 3 steps. Now let's look at another example. This example is more practical. Take a look. Here we have a beautiful woman. I created an animation. I drew this animation freely. I wanted her to scale down at the back of the stage, move to the right, and then come forward. The mask also follows the same movement strategy. I still use the QWL model here to help generate the prompt. Let's look at the final result. This still reflects the issue we mentioned before. Displacement within the 2D plane is relatively easy to achieve, but implementation in the depth dimension is more difficult. After all these tests, what everyone is probably most concerned about is how these three elements are created: the first frame image, the motion video, and the mask. How do we create these? The official source provides a tool. Let's take a look. This tool is called Cut and Drag. Furthermore, it is a graphical tool. You can download this file from this location. The installation is very simple. If you have Python installed, you only need to install these three extension packages. Then you can run the file directly, a window will pop up, and you can perform operations within that window. Now let's look at the specific installation method. First, I establish a virtual environment here. It then installs the corresponding dependency packages. Next, we activate this environment. After that, we install the required extensions. This will be completed quickly. Then we download the Python file and put it into a specific folder. Finally, we just run the Python file directly. At this point, the tool will pop up. Operating within this tool is completely graphical. Now, let's demonstrate the operation method. First, we execute the Python program. We can see a window like this. On the left are some basic function buttons. When selecting, try to choose to crop from the center. Next, let's select a reference image. Note that currently, it only supports landscape orientation. Portrait orientation is not possible. Also, try not to change the frame count setting. You can see it is 81 frames and 16 frames per SECONT. Next, we need to add a polygon. This is a bit like the pen tool in Photoshop. We can box the character out. Try to make your selection as accurate as possible. However, you don't need to strictly hug the edges when selecting. Generally, maintaining an appropriate distance is fine. I'll make a rough selection now. Remember to click to end the polygon selection. At this point, it becomes an editable layer, and the hole in the background is filled in. Now, we can edit its displacement. You can change its displacement using the left mouse button. You can change its size using the round dots on the four corners, and you can rotate it using this control. To set a keyframe, you can click End Segment or use the right mouse button. Notice that the line changes from dash to solid. This means that this segment of the path has been compiled. Then you continue moving forward until you feel the entire path is roughly what you want. Then you can finish editing. When finishing the edit, we can click Save. Then we create a new folder. Note that after selecting this folder, it will prompt you to create a subfolder. The name of this subfolder must not be in Chinese. It must be in English. Otherwise, the first frame image cannot be exported. Let's just type something random. And now the export is successful. You can look at the contents inside. First, there is our first frame image. Then there is our motion video. Further down is our mask video. You just upload these three corresponding pieces of content to their three locations. This technology is actually not a precise guidance technology. Rather, it is a guidance based on trend or form. That is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.